I'm Greg Hollows. Welcome to the Imaging Lab. In this segment, we're going to talk about a specific type of diffuse illumination called a dome light. In this example here, what we're looking at is we have a couple of different domes on the tabletop, and they offer up illumination that gets us around some of the issues that we have with things like ring lights or directional illumination. Ring lights, when we're hitting a flat surface, usually give us a fairly flat illumination profile. When they go into something like a curved surface, as you can see in the image above, or anything that has any sort of topography and high amount of reflectivity, we're getting hot spots. In some of the cases here that you see in this image, they actually have a circular or somewhat circular pattern to them depending on the topography. When we get to something like that, or let's say we're looking at the bottom of this can, and we're trying to read the label that's on here for the date coding and the lot, it can be a little difficult when we use something like a ring light. As you can see in this next image, we got a hot spot that's being formed there that doesn't give us very even illumination. If this label or this information, this printing, moves around at all, that can be a very, very difficult thing to read accurately. And not only will we maybe pass bad parts, there's a good possibility we're going to reject good ones, which can be a real problem. That's where things like this dome light comes in. Dome light, as you can see here, it's curved, it has a dome shape to it, has a hole in it that we're going to have the camera look through, and the lighting is actually reflecting up into the actual dome portion and coming down with a curved geometry to it that is going to somewhat nearly match the bottom of this can surface. So if we're looking at something like a ball bearing or a trailer hitch or something like that, let's say, or this bottom of this can, this curved surface, we end up getting a very flat illumination profile. Let's take a look at the next image here that's showing the same sort of image of this bottom of this can with a dome light. You'll see that we get very, very flat, though it is bright, but flat illumination that's there. And no matter where the code would land on this curved surface, it could be easily read. Imagine again, if we're looking at something like a ball bearing, there's a very curved surface that's running away from us very quickly. The lighting from the dome light is going to be able to wrap around it and give us some sort of response back over the better part of the surface. You can imagine now, as we move closer and closer and closer to that curved surface, it's going to allow us to illuminate things better and better, partially because of the diffusing nature of it, partially because of the angles. It's all about the angles that we talked about in the original segment in the introduction to illumination. It's about geometry. Lighting comes in at some angle, it's going to reflect back off. If I'm at a very, very long distance away, my angles are very, very steep, and there's very little position on a curved surface for the light to reflect back up. It's going to reflect away. As I come down closer and closer, we actually get more oblique angles, and we're actually able to see things. So you can either do it that way, or you can move on to a larger dome like we see here in the front side of the image. Now, some dome lights out there can be as large as a couple meters across to look at very, very large objects. Things like this, with this sort of geometry, it has to be taken into account, which is basically a very complicated, highly topographic reflective surface. You have to consider the size of the lighting that you may need to go into the system beforehand in order to use it effectively. If you're going to look at an object that's, let's say, a foot across, it's going to need a dome light. You might need something that's 2, 3, 4 feet wide, and it's going to be half as tall. You need to account for this when you're putting your system together, because it won't be something that just can be fit in after the fact. So you need to be paying attention to those things. That's dome lights. You can click on any of the links that you like to go on to another illumination section or to the imaging section of your choice.